Hey guys, what's up? Today we're going to talk about a holster I got in from Gunflower. So let's talk about it. All right, so this is a general overview, nothing really specific, but just to let you know that this review is coming out here before too long, once we get some actual time with it. But this is an unboxing, first impressions kind of thing. Technically, I already unboxed it, obviously, but we're just going to talk about first impressions. Now, I shot this video a few days ago when it actually first came in, so a true unboxing. But I had a couple things wrong, and I didn't realize it until afterwards when I was trying to edit the video, and I was like, you know what, let's just reshoot this thing, because I messed it up. So, here we go, this is what we got. But first off, and this is not first off, because we already talked about something, so second off, this holster was sent to me for review on this channel, so take what I say with a grain of salt if you have to, but as you hopefully know, I try to always just give an honest opinion. And I tell people when they send me something, I'm going to tell people the good, I'm going to tell people the bad. If it's good, it's good. If it's bad, it's bad. All right, so that's what I try to do for you guys. That being said, this does look like it is another one of these Chinese holsters, right? So take that with the whatever you want to call it. All right, so now that we got all that stuff out of the way, let's actually talk about this. This is a holster, right, for a Glock. It says on here a Glock 17, right? That's what it says, Glock 17. And then on the sticker, it says Glock 19. So I'm going to assume this is for a Glock 17 because of a couple things, and that's what messed me up on the video before. If you put the, and this is unloaded, right? So anybody that freaks out, whatever. If you put the holster in here like this, right? The holster, if you put the gun in the holster, and I don't know if it's gonna show, probably not, if it will actually show down in there. But for case in point, look at the back of the slide, right? It's flush with the sweat guard right here, right? It's like a high sweat guard. So if we take the gun out, and we put it in here like this, we hold the back of the slide up to the top of the sweat guard, you can see you have about a half inch or whatever of room down in the muzzle end area of the holster, if that makes sense. And generally for a Glock 17, I believe that would give you enough room. And generally for a threaded barrel on a Glock 19, you should be good. Now, the barrel I had in here at the beginning when I shot the other video, it was way too long. It had a very, very long threaded portion that stuck out. So the gun was not clicking in all the way. It would only go in about that far, right? And I was missing this part, right? So this does have a nice solid feel to it. Whenever you holster it, you get an audible tactile click, right? Whenever you holster this, which is nice. That gives you a good feedback when you holster the gun. Because some Kydex holsters out there, a lot of the cheap ones, they do not have any click. It's very mushy. You don't know if you seated it all the way. You don't know if something got stuck in there and now you're pushing against it and you're going to have an ND or something. It's very nice to have a nice audible click, right? Now, they do have one set screw right here. It would be nice if they had two. I would feel a lot more comfortable with two, but they do have one set screw that has like this rubber grommet thing, right? This is kind of the standard way a lot of simple Kydex holsters like this are made, to where that's where your attention comes from. If you screw that out, it won't grab the gun as hard. If you screw it in a little bit further, I think it could go a little bit further, but I got it screwed down pretty tight. Then it just makes it a little bit more snug fitting. And the gun shouldn't be falling out. Now, if I just took this and just used inertia and popped it out, it would pop out. But even a high name brand holster is going to do that, right? This has no switches or buttons or things you have to do to get the gun to unlock, right? It's just a friction fit. So another real quick key feature of this that I see, and then we're just going to kind of wrap up this overall initial impression, is that this is set up for a right-handed shooter, right? Or a right side draw, for the gun to be oriented for a right hand, basically, okay? The way that you know that is it has a sweat guard on the left side, right? There's no sweat guard on the right side. And you have your belt clip over here on this side, which would allow you to carry inside the waistband, right? Because your belt would go through here, snug everything up against next to you. A cool thing, we'll see how cool it is, we'll see how practical it is you have these holes on the opposite side, right? On the non-ejection port cover side of the gun, right? The left-hand side of the gun. you have these little holes which would allow you to take this clip off of the right-hand side, mount it on the left-hand side, and then run it as an outside-the-waistband holster. So you kind of get the best of both worlds in a way, at least in theory. We were going to try that out, but in theory, that's what you get. So you'll be able to use the same holster for inside-the-waistband or outside-the-waistband, depending on what your needs are. Now, all right, so that is one thing that does seem to be potentially a very good thing, right? To give you some flexibility and stuff. Now, most of the time when a product is a jack of all trades, that means it's not a master of any of them, right? But for some cases, if this guy works really well, it could be one of those good holsters to keep in a range bag or to keep a spare just in case something happens to another holster, or a buddy needs to borrow something or whatever, or you carry this and you bring it to the range because you want to practice inside the waistband and you don't want to spend the money for another holster, so you want to practice outside the waistband too, so you can just flip your clip over, if that makes any sense. All right, so that pretty much covers our first initial impressions of this. This is not a review because I have not even put this thing on yet, but I'm going to give it probably a week or 2 weeks or whatever before we actually do a review on this and try to get some actual time with it. Some actual draws, actual practice and stuff like that, inside, outside the waistband, all that kind of stuff. If you got any questions about it, please do let me know. And again, just take what I say with a grain of salt. This was sent to me by Gunflower. Highlight it right there for you guys, Gunflower, right? It was sent to me by them. So do with that information as you see fit, all right? Hope you guys enjoyed that. Y'all be good to be safe. Hopefully we'll catch y'all in the next video.